Milan, how many times do people say anything in the lines of, I'm going to file a complaint or I'll tell corporate about this each day? Before we address this question, yes, I know they said Milan. I love when people mispronounce my name. I don't know why it's so funny to me. But I would be lying if I said every single day somebody comes in and says they're going to file a complaint to corporate. But when it does happen, oh boy, it's a fiasco. So if I'm being real, on the daily, we probably have like 1 to 2 total entitled customers total for the entire day. And it's not like I'm going to deal with them each time. But when you've been working at Subway for about 6 years like me, well, you've seen your fair share of people that just want to complain. So whenever somebody does tell me that they're going to file a complaint to corporate or that they're going to tell corporate about whatever happened in their experience, I tell them that it's completely okay and that they're more than welcome to do so, because there's just no point in arguing with somebody. I mean, I like to give a free cookie. If I think I messed up somebody's sandwich, I'm always willing to give them a refund, or I'm always willing to give them even another sandwich. But there is a small percentage of people out there that just love to complain. Like, I swear there's people out there that literally just want to ruin your day. And although it's not intentionally, I mean, if I give you a full refund and I give you a free sandwich back and you still say that you're going to report me to corporate, I mean, like, at that point you're kind of headhunting, if I'm being honest. But this one particular case, I made a video about somebody that told me that their sandwich was burnt. I literally made a short about it too, and I think it got like a couple million views on it. And the woman said that I burnt her sandwich, so I kindly just told her, okay, I'll make you a new one. I don't think it's burnt, but I'm going to take it to the back. And she was like low-key trying to take that sandwich as well. And it made zero sense to me. You told me that I burnt and ruined your sandwich, and now you want that sandwich as well as the other one that I'm making for you? You see, something here doesn't add up. And at the end, she literally told me, who's your corporate manager? I'm going to report them to corporate. And I literally gave her the site that you can file complaints on with Subway to a T. Literally the URL, but I don't think she ever filed a complaint, which is good. I mean, like, I guess she went home and really processed what was happening, or she was just too lazy to file a complaint, but I don't think anything beats this other person. So there was a day that I was just working my shift at Subway, and I was all alone. And usually at nighttime, it's pretty dead. Like, we will get not too many customers and not really a line. At least we used to not. This was like a few years ago. And in this particular case, I had 3 customers online. Now, I like to consider myself a little fast with making sandwiches. I mean, I think I'm faster than the average Subway worker, not to brag or anything. It's literally just making a sandwich. But by the time I got to the 3rd customer, about 5 or 6 minutes had to have passed. And she told me, this is ridiculous that I have to wait and that you're the only person working here. I don't think I should ever have to wait while I'm going to a Subway. Literally a food place. She said that she doesn't think that she has to wait. And I was kind of like giving her the runabouts. I was like, yeah, I'm really sorry. Like, we don't usually get busy like this, etc., etc. And the whole time she was just finding stuff to complain about. Like, as I was making her sandwich, she was telling me that I didn't put enough meat on it when I was just following the Subway formula. She told me that my veggie game was weak and that I forgot to toast her sandwich. So I literally had to take the vegetables off and then re-toast her sandwich and then bring it back out. It was this whole like headache, but I didn't mind. I was like, okay, this comes with the job, like whatever. But then at the end, she started telling me how she was going to report me to my manager. And I said to her something along the lines of like, I don't think I have a manager. Like, I am the manager. And then at that point, she kind of lost it. She basically said something along the lines of, since you're not going to do anything about this, I'm going straight to corporate and I'm going to tell them all about this. And I'm going to make sure that they fix the problem here. And I'm just looking at this woman like, you know, you go do that. You go, Glen Coco. Empowerment. And she went and reported the whole thing to corporate. And we got an email from corporate that day and they were like, hey, what happened? And basically after just explaining the entire situation, corporate was like, yeah, that's kind of ridiculous that a customer would have done that. You're fine. We're going to throw them a free cookie offer and that'll be the end of that. But these corporate stories, man, they don't end there. There are so many instances where customers have reported to corporate, and maybe one day I can even bring up a couple of the complaints. Today's secret word is Milan. So if you're at this point of the video and you're hearing this, make sure you comment something down below with the word Milan in it. Let me know if you guys would want to see that. Subscribe to the channel and peace.